friends, today is a crucial day for us for many reasons. Time shrinks, and as time shrinks, dates in the calendar overlap. कोई रेलगाड़ी जैसा किस्सा है, जैसे रेलगाड़ी में आजकल 50 साल 100 साल से पहले से आजकल बहुत ज़्यादा लोग होते हैं, उसी तरह हमारे कैलेंडर में भी बहुत सारी जो क्यूब्स हैं, क्यूबिकल्स हैं, वो भरते जाते हैं, इवेंट्स जैसे बढ़ते जाते हैं. अक्टूबर 2 को लीजिए, वो गांधी जी की सालगिरह ही नहीं, वो लाल बहादुर शास्त्री जी की भी सालगिरह है. और हम जो दक्षिण में हैं जानते हैं, इट इज़ ऑल्सो द डेथ एनिवर्सरी ऑफ द ग्रेट तमिल लीडर हु स्टेबिलाइज्ड आवर कंट्री एट क्रूशियल मोमेंट्स, के कामराज. अक्टूबर 31 इज लाइक दैट. इट हैज़ बीन ever since public memory assimilated the fact of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, his birth anniversary. But it has also now become the anniversary of what Siddhartha Varadarajan, in a brilliant article in today's Times of India, has described as the day and the first of two or three days when nearly 5,000 innocent Sikhs were murdered in cold blood in the wake of the tragic assassination of Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. So all these have come together. It is a fact. And how is this relevant to Bharat, Bhagya, Vidhata? I'll hope I'll be able to explain in a few moments. But it is a fact that for the greater part of the decades since independence and since Sardar Patel, after a dramatic 3 years in which he accomplished so much, passed away, it is a fact that he has been obscured by the power centers of our time. और इसमें कई राज हैं जो कि सिर्फ सियासत से नहीं जुड़े हैं, हम सब की एक दिमागी तबीयत से और हमारे दिमाग से जुड़े हुए हैं. Why has this happened? Particularly after जवाहरलाल नेहरू, a kind of psychosis was created about anniversaries in which the Mahatma's anniversaries became almost sort of ritual anniversaries, but then others kept adding up, making anniversaries themselves something of a tedious affair. I remember once I caught in a traffic jam in Delhi, and from one my auto in which I was sitting, talking to the auto driver of the next auto, for some reason my auto driver was very silent, sullen. I, kya baat hai, traffic kyun ruka hua yahan? रिंग रोड में था, इसे होगा किसी का जन्मदिन किसी का मरण दिन. नाउ इट हैज कम टू दिस, इट हैड कम टू दिस, बट इन दैट टाइट पैकिंग ऑफ एनिवर्सरीज द सरदार्स बर्थ एनिवर्सरी बिकेम मिस्टीरियसली ऑब्स्क्योर्ड. वी हैड द स्टैच्यू ऑफ हिम, बट इट वॉज बाईपास्ड. एंड देन व्हेन 31st October बिकेम लिंक्ड with the assassination of Mrs. Indira Gandhi, it was completely bypassed. And so today, if a contrastive political formation is evoking the Sardar, it is correcting a major lapse, but it is doing so for its own reasons. We must remember that. We must know that. The attention that the Sardar is being paid today is being criticized not very frontally yet, but in sort of murmurs by the Congress as an appropriation of the Sardar legacy by the BJP. Perhaps it is, but before the Congress can really criticize the BJP or our Prime Minister for training very strong arc lights on the Sardar as a kind of misuse of the Sardar legacy. The Congress must ask itself if it is not also guilty of the disuse of the Sardar legacy. Before anybody can blame the new ruling establishment of India for what has sometimes been called the counterfeiting of Sardar Patel, the previous political formation must ask itself if it had not forfeited the Sardar legacy. How does this link to Bharat Bhagya Vidhata? For this reason, that in a very essential way and definitive foundational way, for that period 47 to 50, Sardar Patel was in charge of the Bhagya of our political cartology. It is not an accident that he was made Home Minister and Minister for the States. He had come from Gujarat, where he knew the functioning of the princely states, their minds. He was also aware of the great contributions made, say, particularly by the Maharaja of Baroda, who was a definitive figure, a person whom we should know more about, Maharaja Sayaji Rao III of Baroda. So Sardar knew all this, and there was some method in his being Home Minister. And his bringing the 554 states together was literally a kind of a nirman, and he was the nirmata of our republic. Of that there can be no doubt. But we must rewind a bit. The phrase, as you all know, is from Rabindranath's great song. And as was mentioned, the Bangla version of the song is far more fulfilling than the version, than the song as it is sung. The version is the same, but as it is sung. And when you say Bharat Bhagya Vidhata, there is something to that. It is like eating a fruit with one's own hands rather than with cutlery. You know what I mean. It's like that. Now, when he wrote this song, a Congress session was taking place. A great Delhi Darbar was taking place. And the first and last time, the Emperor of India, as he was called, George V and his queen, were on Indian soil. And there is a completely baseless but very persistent interpretation that the phrase Bharat Bhagya Vidhata in the song was Tagore's way of welcoming the King Emperor. Now this is baseless, but it is not without some, shall we say, some excuse, some reason which the song itself gives. Because later on he speaks, not in the version we sing, but in the fuller version, he later on sings of the king of kings, Raja Rajeshwara. So there was some internal content to the song which led people to think ki shayad inhone Badshah Salamat ke liye likha hai. Whereas that was not the case at all. As he himself very emphatically said, that I'm not so stupid as to write this for the king emperor. But he has used the phrase Bharat Bhagya Vidhata. And earlier, he has used the phrase Adhinayaka, Adhinayaka. Now, this was in 1911-12. The song was a kind of a younger sibling of another amazing song, Vande Mataram, written by the great Bankim as part of his novel Anandamath, which was published in 1882. Vande Mataram sings of fecund India. Shujalam, Shufalam, Valayaja Sheetalam. So does the Janaganamana. But thanks, in my case, many of you would have known the song in its fullness, but in my case, I came across or I stumbled upon the full text in the Ashram Bhajanavali compiled by M.K. Gandhi. Now, you don't associate M.K. Gandhi with songs and music and dance and drama, but actually he was a very aesthetically self-contained person. So in what is a unique publication, the Bhajanavali for his ashram, he has the full text of Janaganamana, in which I came across this passage, which an earlier generation knew automatically because they knew all the five stanzas of Janaganamana. But I, sort of largely post-independence creature, inured only to the official version of the anthem, did not know about it. And in my mind, the unexpurgated Janaganamana should be read by all of us. Not to say ki are official version mein ye sab kyun chhod diya hai, isliye nahi. Koi bhi national anthem bahut 22 ye koi 51 52 second ka hai. Wo 3-4 minute tak ka koi national anthem nahi hota hai, chhota sa hi hota hai. Aur usme zara umang hona chahiye. Par ye jo pura jo national anthem hai Gurudev ka gaan, jo ki baad mein national anthem bana, usme there is a chiaroscuro of moods, like his sensibility. It has everything. It has pain and pleasure. It has sorrow and happiness. But the most important, in my view, passages or lines from the song are the following. Ghor timira ghana nibira nishidhe. Itna to hum log sab samajh jayenge. Kisi zaruri nahi ki Bangla hi janna chahiye. Ghor timira ghana nibira nishidhe. This is Tagore in Janaganamana. Pidito murchito deshi. Dushopne. Atunke. Rukha korile onke. Snehamai tumi mata. Now, Snehamai tumi mata itself shows that he was not addressing this to the king emperor. Because the king emperor, whatever else he was not a Snehamai mata. So, all these. And you can imagine a Dhrupad singer going into ecstasies with Ghora Timira Ghana Ghora 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 Ghana Ghana Ghora Ghora Timira Ghana. It really is the most fantastic part of that song. But it is fantastic not just for its Dhrupadic possibilities. It is fantastic because of its thingness, its innerness. Now, why does he talk of Ghora Timira Ghana? He talks about Ghora Timira Ghana because he is aware of the darkness of the soul of India, in the soul of India. And he's not talking only of colonialism and imperialism. He's talking of timira, nibida, pida, pidita murchita deshi. Now, a country like this needs to have somebody who redeems it, Bhagya Vidhata. And he is referring to what? Now, if you were to ask an abstract painter, aap iska meaning bataiye. So abstract painter is not going to spend his time. Wo yehi kahega ki aap jo iska maina nikal sakte hain, isse aap nikaliyega. That is what Tagore would have also said, I think, if he was asked to give a paraphrasing of Bharat Bhagya Vidhata, of Ghora Timira Ghana Nibira Nishide. But the fact is that he was appealing to something, to some ineffable power, maybe the Godhead, or maybe the people's own sensibility, to redeem India from its bhag. Now, track for a little forward. Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, we know, has given us the national greeting of Jai Hind. Every country, every sovereign country, prides itself in its little kit of sovereign emblems. There is a national anthem everywhere. There is a national symbol. India being India, we have found a very Indian solution to the great option that we had between Vande Mataram and Janaganamana for our national anthem by saying Janaganamana will be the national anthem, Vande Mataram will be the national song. It's a very typical Indian solution. And thank God for the Indian genius which can come up with such solutions, because both were compelling, compelling competitors. 19-20 ka farak nahi tha, 19.5 sawa 21 ka farak tha. But Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, sitting in Germany, setting up the Free India Center in Hamburg, casts about for a song which could be the national anthem of India. And that man's confidence was something. You have to hand it to Subhash Bose. He had confidence, if anybody has ever had confidence. He decided that this will be the national anthem of future India. 41. This is before the Quit India movement. And he decided it will be Janaganamana. That is the year Tagore died too. So Janaganamana had been almost predestined to become the national anthem of India. And one can say, human nature being what it is, that when Netaji was thinking of this as a national anthem, he may have thought that there will be a coalescence between the Vidhata and the Adhinayaka, whom Tagore has thought of, and whatever it is that has made him what he is, it is Netaji. And there were certainly people who thought that Netaji was destined to be the Adhinayaka of India. There is, therefore, a continuum between what is called the sense of the desire for a powerful force that should pull India out of its timira, nibira, ghona, ghana, ghora, darkness into the light of freedom and the light of the future. But such is the interplay of forces that in 1947, 15th of August, when all eyes would have really been picturing, hungering for Netaji to unfurl that flag on the Red Fort, it was given to Pandit Nehru to unfurl it, and in a remarkably gracious and most historically, magnetically imperative statement, say, and it is a remarkable speech of his. I would say it is in terms not of lyrical beauty, but in terms of inner, in the luminosity of its truthfulness, at a higher stature than the one famously called the Tryst with Destiny speech. He says in that, these are not his exact words because I'm doing disservice to them. I'm not quoting him, but I'm referring to him. He says, ye jo aaj jhanda uncha aap hote dekh rahe hain, ye kisi aur ke haath se hone ka tha. Ye Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose ke haath se hone ka tha. The only name he invokes that day apart from Gandhi is that of Netaji. So that is the kind of gracious historical sense which did not say so-and-so is bigger than so-and-so, so-and-so has been left out, so-and-so should come back. No running for competition, no running for attention, no greedy grasping of media attention. It was a sharing. There were huge differences between Nehru and Bose, as a very good new book by Rudraksh Mukherjee, Nehru and Bose, tells us. There were huge differences between Sardar Patel and Nehru, but there was also an enormous accommodation. Sardar Patel and Gandhi very rightly described today, earlier today by our Prime Minister, as having been inseparable. True, he is absolutely right. Prime Minister Modi has said something which is historically unexceptionable, and in fact also narratively essential to relate. He says, ki ek ke bina dusra adhura tha. I'll tell you, the two Bhagya Vidhatas, if they can be called that, or sharers of the Vidhata role. Why were Gandhi and Patel so close? Gandhi or Nehru, unko hum safar kaha ja sakta hai, hum dam bhi kaha ja sakta hai. But Gandhi or Vallabhbhai Patel, wo hum mazak the, hum jamaat the. जेल में गांधी एक दिन रवड़ा जेल में, दोनों साथ कैदी हैं, एक ही सेल में हैं। गांधी कहते हैं कि सबको मरना है, मेरा दिन भी आएगा, वो चार कंधे तैयार हैं जिनमें मुझे चढ़ना है। सरदार पटेल लुक्स अप फ्रॉम वॉट एवर ही इज डूइंग, पहले हमारी नाव को पार उतार दो, फिर जहां मर्जी हो जाना जाओ, तब जाओ, जिसके कंधे पर चढ़ना हो चढ़ो। देन इन सेम जेल गांधी गेट्स ए लेटर, हेट मेल अब सिर्फ ईमेल में हमें ही नहीं आते हैं, उस जमाने से भी आते थे। और ये एनोनिमस हेट मेल जो है ना, वो तो हमारी हिंदुस्तान की एक अलग एक शख्सियत दिखाती है, आवर स्पेशल जॉनर क्रिएटेड इन इंडिया। वैसी एक एनोनिमस हेट मेल गांधी को आती है और वो खोल के पढ़ते हैं। हेट मेल थी तो इसलिए जेल वालों ने गांधी जी को पहुंचा भी दी, लव मेल होती तो गांधी को वो पहुंचाते नहीं। तो जेल में हेट मेल को देखकर गांधी जी सरदार पटेल को कहते हैं, क्या लिखा है इसने जानते हो, इसको मैं क्या जवाब दूं? सरदार पटेल लुक्स अप टू हिम एंड सेज, उसको कहो कि जहर पी के मर जाए। दिस वॉज सरदार पटेल रगेड नो नॉनसेंस प्रैक्टिकलिटी। ही वॉज इन जेल, ही वॉज सफरिंग एज मच एज गांधी, बट दैट वॉज द काइंड ऑफ पॉजिटिव स्पिरिट इन द मैन, एंड दैट पॉजिटिव स्पिरिट मेड हिम फर्ल हिज प्राइड एंड वर्क एज डिप्यूटी प्राइम मिनिस्टर अंडर नेहरू, बिकॉज ही न्यू दैट उनके लिए चार कंधे जो तैयार थे वो बहुत करीब थे। 75 साल की उम्र थी उनकी, नासाज थे, नाराज नहीं थे, नासाज थे। और तरुण तपस्वी जवाहरलाल नेहरू, यूथफुल लीडर, इंटरनेशनली नोन, फ्लुएंट इन हिंदुस्तानी, इंग्लिश, पर्हैप्स फ्रेंच एंड जर्मन एज वेल, सो ही गेव हिम एवरी सपोर्ट। दैट वॉज द शेयरिंग ऑफ द नॉट भाग्य विधाता रोल, बट ऑफ द भाग्य विधाता नीड। सो भाग्य विधाता इज नॉट अ पोजिशन, इट इज अ नीड। दैट इज समथिंग विच रविंद्रनाथ न्यू, नेताजी न्यू, सरदार पटेल न्यू, गांधी जी न्यू, एंड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंटली पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू न्यू इन द वे ही एक्नॉलेज्ड द नीड एंड शेयर्ड द अपॉर्चुनिटी विद एवरी सिंगल पर्सन। नाउ इन द रिमेनिंग 10 मिनट्स डू आई हैव वाइस चांसलर और 15, मैं बहुत बोल, मैं जल्दी ख़त्म कर दूँ तो फिर 10-15 मिनट आपका वक्त दूंगा। आज के माहौल में अगर हम तिमिर, निबिड़, पीड़ा, मूर्छा, दुष्स्वप्न और आतंक को, सारे गुरुदेव के अल्फाज हैं, अगर हम उनको देखें तो क्या क्या हमें दिखता है। एंड बिफोर आई कम टू दैट आई हैव टू रेफर वो 1921 बात। 1920 के बीच में एक मेडिसिनाइन क्लेमेंट फॉर आर सोल, फॉर आर लव, फॉर द एम्ब्रेस ऑफ आर एस्थेटिक एंड नेशनल प्राइड वॉज इकबाल सारे जहां से अच्छा। आई फील दैट द इंडियन जीनियस विच मेड वंदे मातरम द नेशनल सॉन्ग शुड हैव ऑल्सो मेड सारे जहां से अच्छा अनदर नेशनल सॉन्ग। If we had had two national songs, when we can have one national song, which is a very imaginative solution to the dilemma, we could have had two. And imagine what that would have done to what today is being called by our Prime Minister so rightly the need for unity. Just as we know Janaganamana, but we do not know the expurgated portion, no fault of ours, hum सफा पढ़ेंगे या कतरन पढ़ेंगे, सफा ही तो पढ़ेंगे, जो कट गया वो कट गया। लेकिन द ब्यूटी ऑफ तिराना हिंद इज दैट वो उसी में है, लेकिन क्योंकि अलग जो उसके अलादा जो जुमले हैं वो इतने गजब के हैं कि वो हमारे दिमाग में एक किस्म से छप गए हैं। वो ऐसे जोर से छप गए हैं कि ये जुमला छिप गया है। सिलसिला ऐसा है, हम सब जानते हैं, मज़हब नहीं सिखाता, कुछ बात है कि हस्ती. लेकिन द फ्रेजेस विच आई रियली क्लिंग टू इन इकबाल्स ग्रेट सॉन्ग, इकबाल कोई महरम अपना नहीं जहां में, मालूम क्या किसी को दर्दे निहां हमारा. नाउ द हमारा इन दिस इज नॉट रेफरिंग टू एनी पर्टिकुलर कॉम. ही इज नॉट रेफरिंग टू द इस्लामिक पॉपुलेशन ऑफ इंडिया. ही इज नॉट रेफरिंग टू एनी पर्टिकुलर पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया. हर एक में दर्द होता है. वो दर्द कोई और जाने, वो हमदर्द कहाँ है. दिस इज हिज पॉइंट. Now, Tagore's Timiraghana, Aatunke, Dushupne, and Allama Iqbal's Darde Niha Hamara. These are what constitute the need for a Vidhata, the need for a Adhinayak. Not, Adhinayak does not mean setting up a corporation for development and construction. Adhinayak is for the Dard-e-Hind, and that Dard-e-Hind is what can be encapsulated in the following few, shall I say, depictions of India. Timira and Nibira refer to the widespread ignorance in us, and I'm not referring to the standard definition of ignorance as coming from non-literacy. There is no such thing as illiteracy. Because illiteracy is also, you know, it amounts to saying, mujhe uski zarurat nahi hai, mujhe uski fikr nahi, mujhe nahi chahiye, wo jaye. Non-literacy. Like non-numeracy. Hum non-numerate nahi hai. Hisab hum sabko bahut aata hai. Non-literate hai. Par main us non-literacy ki baat nahi kar raha hun. Ignorance of each other. अगर फर्ज करी जो गांधी जी चाहते थे कि हिंदुस्तानी बोलनी चाहिए, सिर्फ हिंदी नहीं, ये नहीं कि वो संस्कृत के खिलाफ थे, ये नहीं कि वो नहीं चाहते थे कि संस्कृत पढ़ जाए. उनको वंदे मातरम में बहुत मानते थे. वंदे मातरम को कहते थे कि इसमें उस तरह की खूबसूरत संस्कृत कहाँ मिलेगी, इसको आप ज़रूर सब जानिए, गाइए. लेकिन हिंदुस्तानी क्यों? क्योंकि वो जो मेल है, वो जो मिश्रण है, जो मिलाप, जो मिलन है, उसमें एक को दूसरे का एहसास मिलता है. अगर सारे जहाँ से अच्छा फ़र्ज करिए नेशनल सॉन्ग बना होता और हर बच्चा उसको गाता, तो उसके मन में कुछ होता कि मैं ज़रा जानूँ. बाद में उसको मालूम होता कि अल्लामा इकबाल, अच्छा वो पाकिस्तान का भी, पाकिस्तान का तरह भी उन्होंने लिखा, अच्छा ये क्यों हुआ. ज़रा एक किस्म से क्यूरियोसिटी जगती. लेकिन नहीं, जो तिमिर और निबिड़ है, it is about not being able to see the other point of view. Ignorance, darkness in our minds about the other point of view. And this extends to not just different faith traditions, different political traditions, but just different persons, human to human. We do not care enough. How many people in Tamil Nadu know Telugu? Only the Carnatic musicians, because of Tyagaraj. And thank God for that, because many rasikas of Carnatic music therefore get to hear Telugu and to understand the beauty of Telugu. But otherwise, not really. Kannada, similarly. Likewise, Marathi and Gujarati. Very few people are bilingual between Bangla and Uriya. That being the case, we are in Timira and Nibira. But most importantly, and this is where Rabindranath's imagination can be mined indefinitely, we are just unable to have dialogue. Take today. Ittefaq se cheeze hoti hain ek din, ek tarikh. Ittefaq se jud jati hain kisi ki zindagi se aur kisi ke maut se. किसी के पैदाइश से और किसी के जाने से. लेकिन अब हमारे मुल्क में पैदाइश बट गई है, शहादत बट गई है। भारत को हम कहते हैं अंग्रेजों ने विभाजित किया, हम उसको हर रोज विभाजित कर रहे हैं। पीड़ा, फ्रॉम टैगोर अगेन फ्रॉम द सेम टू लाइन्स, एक्सप्लॉयटेशन particularly in the matter of caste. And this is where the biggest, surely the finest name which can be attached to the Vidhata and Adhinayak need is that of Baba Sahib Ambedkar. There is no question of it. Without that man filling in the interstices of Republic in India's needs, we would not have been what we are conceptually, constitutionally, legally, politically. What Sardar Patel did to the cartography of India, Ambedkar did to the political conscience of India. Lekin unhone jo kiya, so unhone kiya, hum kya kar rahe hain? And I will not tax your time or your patience with talking about what all of us know, which is the exploitation of the women of India. I do not think we can claim any role in the world better than being the most aggressively and shamelessly male-dominated society. Who has dushyopnas? Everyone knows a bully. And the first bully, literally the first bully, with great dramatic exceptions, which only prove the rule, is the dominant male in the house, at home. But bullyism is found in every nukkad in our cities. Katra, kucha, gali, ye jo har ek jagah aapko ye shakhs, ye sahab zarur milenge. But most importantly, in politics. And that brings me finally to Atanko. Now, when Tagore wrote Atanko, he knew of the tradition of political violent terrorism in Bengal. 1907 had already happened. Aurobindo had already moved from politics to spirituality, gone to Pondicherry. So he knew what, but he was not using Atanko in the literal sense in which we today use it, which is terrorism, quote unquote. He was talking of fear. And this connects to his great song, which he wrote 2 years before Janaganamana, which all of you know of, in its more in the English translation, where the mind is without fear. Now, isme bhi aap dekhiyega, tarjume ke kitna bhi acha ho tarjuma, uski seemaein hoti hai. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, jo hai, wo zara formula sa ban gaya hai. Agar baar baar usko bahane gaane ko kahe, kehne ko kahe, to usme uska jo ras hai, वो आम जो है वो अमचूर भी नहीं, वो अमचूर का चूर बन जाएगा. चित्तो जैठा भय शून्य, चित्तो जैठा भय शून्य, उच्चो जैठा शीर. नाउ दिस इज समथिंग विच इज अनट्रांसलेटेबल, पर्टिकुलरली अनट्रांसलेटेबल बाय टैगोर हिमसेल्फ, बिकॉज ही वॉज सिस्टमैटिकली डूइंग द ग्रेटेस्ट डिसर्विस टू हिज ओन कॉम्पोजिशंस व्हेन ही ट्रांसलेटेड दम. जब किसी बड़े से बड़े किसी कवि को कहा जाए कि आप ही इसका तर्जुमा भी कर दीजिए, तो वो उस कवि के साथ इंसाफ नहीं होता. नाउ दैट भय शून्य, अक्टूबर 31, व्हाई डिड वी नॉट इवन रिमेंबर, व्हाई डिड वी नॉट रिमेंबर इज नॉट द राइट फ्रेज, व्हाई डिड वी चूज नॉट टू रिमेंबर सरदार वल्लभ भाई पटेल्स बर्थडे इन हिज सेंटिनरी ईयर. 1975. Because 1975 was when the national emergency was on. Boy, boy, boy. मजाल है कोई सरदार पटेल की सेंटेनरी का वो कोई प्रस्ताव भी प्रधानमंत्री के सामने रखता. सेंटेनरी साहब वो आई और गई. भय. मेरे भाई साहब का जिक्र हुआ है तो आपको ये भी बता दूं, रामचंद्र गांधी, रामू गांधी तब सेंट स्टीफन्स कॉलेज में फिलॉसफी डिपार्टमेंट में होते थे और तब साइन होते थे सब कमरों में, बातें कम काम ज़्यादा. तो उन्होंने उसका ज़रा संशोधन किया, बातें कम चाय ज़्यादा. मजाक ही एक तरीका होता है भय से वंचित होने का. कभी कभी चार्ल्स लैम ने कहा है ना, वर्ड्सवर्थ ने कहा है चार्ल्स लैम के बारे में, ही लाफ्ड इन ऑर्डर नॉट टू वीप. तो वही सिलसिला था. और मैं आपको बताऊं, गुमनाम सरदार पटेल को अगर हम आज वापस अपने दिलों में ला रहे हैं तो वो हमें खुले दिल और खुश दिल से लाना चाहिए. आज भी अगर हम कोई भय से अगर उनकी सालगिरह मनाने लगे तो भय को बस भय ही बनता रह गया. उनको भुलाना भय से हुआ, उनको याद करना भय से नहीं होना चाहिए. ये बहुत ज़रूरी है. लेकिन ये जो भय है वो हमारे देश, इससे हमें कौन उठाएगा? आई नाउ फोल्ड अप. गनीमत है कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अथॉरिटीज करके एक हमारे देश में कोई चीज़ है. जुडिशरी में ज़रूर हो सकते हैं कोई ऐसे जिनको जुडिशरी में नहीं होना चाहिए था, लेकिन जुडिशरी जुडिशरी है, वो हमारी एक बहुत बड़ी चीज़ है. कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अथॉरिटीज़ जो कहते हैं, चीफ इलेक्शन कमिश्नर, चीफ विजिलेंस कमिश्नर, चीफ इन्फॉर्मेशन कमिश्नर, CAG, ये सब भारत भाग्य विधाता की ज़रूरत को पूरा करते हैं, उसके पूरक हैं. पर इनसे भी ज़्यादा चुनावों के ज़रिए हम अपने विधाताओं को नहीं विधायकों को चुनते हैं. तो विधायक को विधाता कैसे बनाएं, ये जो एक विडंबना है, इसको हमने एक बहुत ही बढ़िया एक किस्म से देखा है RTI के आंदोलन से. आज RTI का जो नाम है, दोज थ्री इनिशियल्स आर नोन इन एवरी विलेज ऑफ इंडिया. अंग्रेजी जानते हो न हो, लिटरेट हो न हो, नॉन लिटरेट हो न हो, RTI जानते हैं. उसका बहुत दुरुपयोग भी होता है. किसी बेचारे छोटे से अफसर को उसकी नाक रगड़ने के लिए भी RTI का यूज़ होता है, तो वो भी हिंदुस्तान की जीनियस है. लेकिन मोटे तौर पर RTI जो है वो ये दिखाता है कि भारत के भाग्य का निर्माण भारत के लोगों से खुद हो सकता है और होता है. उदाहरण मैं नहीं दूंगा क्योंकि वो बहुत पर्सनल हो जाते हैं कि किस किस के पोल खुले हैं RTI के ज़रिए. जयप्रकाश जी की मूवमेंट, उन्होंने अपने आप को लोकनायक नहीं कहा, औरों ने उनको लोकनायक कहा. जैसे कि रविंद्रनाथ ने नेताजी सुभाष चंद्र बोस को देशनायक कहा था, औरों ने जयप्रकाश जी को लोकनायक कहा, क्योंकि वो भी 77 में भारत के भाग्य के विधाता की ज़रूरत को पूरा कर रहे थे. हाल में ऐसे और भी हमने मूवमेंट्स देखे हैं जिनका मैं उल्लेख करूंगा तो लगेगा कि मैं आज की पार्टी पॉलिटिक्स की बात कर रहा हूं, तो मैं नहीं करूंगा. बट द पॉइंट इज दैट द एबिलिटी टू बिकम द अधिनायकर्स एंड द विधाताज ऑफ भारत हैज़ बीन entrusted by the hands of Gurudev and Netaji, Vallabh Bhai Patel, Pandit Nehru and Baba Sahib Ambedkar to all of us. And if we are vigilant and if we remain true to what they wanted us to be, we will fulfill the vision of our national anthem and the fulfillment of what Netaji encapsulated in his national greeting, Jai Hind. Aur jo Jai Hai aur Jai Hind ki jo khush ittefaqi hai, us par bhi aap zara gaur kariyega. Woh Son of India ke 62 mein ek film aayi thi, usme Nanna Munna Rahi Hoon jo ek gana hoga, aapne suna hoga. Uske ant mein jo Jai Hind aata hai, wo Gurudev ke Jai Hai se bilkul taal rakhta hai. Uska lay aur Gurudev ke Jai Hind ka lay bilkul taal lay dono ek hai. To ye hum yaad rakhein. Aur aakhir mein main aap sab se mujhe is mauka dene ke liye apna shukriya kehkar aapse ijazat leta hoon.